Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to do the topic Warp Power and Energy, which is a chapter 2 of class 10 syllabus. And I think I've completed with you in the class 2A and I guess some parts of 2B and 2C also. So let's just consider on few remaining portions of this chapter. Okay. I've written this for you. First of all, what is mechanical energy? You have all read about this. Mechanical energy is the energy which is possessed by a body by virtue of position or configuration or movement. It is of two types. You all know potential energy, kinetic energy, right? So what is potential energy? The energy or the mechanical energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position or configuration. Now when I'm speaking about position, okay? That means I am speaking about the gravitational potential energy. For example, if I just place a flower tub, say, on roof on the terrace of a building. So, or say suppose I lift a stone in my hand from the ground. So, I am just holding the stone at some height from the ground. So, that means the energy possessed by the stone now due to the raised position, okay, that is gravitational potential energy. What about the elastic potential energy? Elastic potential energy means the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its configuration. That means suppose a rubber band. If you stretch a rubber band, it will be deformed. Now this type of energy, you can very well relate that it's applicable for non-rigid bodies. Okay. Non-rigid bodies means those bodies which will be deformed, which will be showing change in shape or configuration applying some external force. Otherwise, if it is a rigid body, it will either move, say it will show some translational motion, or it will say show some rotational motion, because if it's a rigid body. In case of non-rigid body, if I apply some external force, say for example rubber band, we will find that it will be deformed in its shape or configuration. So the energy acquired by the body, that means the work done in order to deform it from its original shape and configuration, that is known as the elastic potential energy. And once we release the force, that means once we withdraw the external force from the body, it will again regain its original shape and configuration. Due to which property? Elasticity. This was taught in the previous class. Elasticity, that means the property of our body by which it can regain its original shape and configuration once the external force is withdrawn. Now, kinetic energy. You all know that kinetic energy is possessed by a body by virtue of the movement. Examples I'm not giving because you know very well. Three types of kinetic energy. Translational kinetic energy, that means suppose a car moving along a straight line. Vibrational, say you pluck the strings of a guitar. Rotational, say for example, earth rotating on its axis. For example, if a bowler throws a ball, it will possess, the ball will possess two types of energy. Translational energy, because it's moving forward. Also, rotational energy. Okay, so these are the basics. Now let's just come to some mathematical form. When we are saying gravitational potential energy, how is work done on a body due to the raised position? Because work is done against the force of gravity. Because the gravitational attraction of Earth on any body will try to pull it downwards. But we are trying to raise the body. That means we are doing some work against the force of gravity. So, the energy, the work done on the body will be stored in the body in the form of gravitational potential energy. So, we know work done, it will be stored in the form of gravitational potential energy, which is denoted as. So, U is equal to force. We all know work done is force into displacement. So, what is the force here? The force of gravity, which is acting downwards. Now, why am I writing mg? Because force is mass into acceleration due to gravity. into displacement. Say the body is displaced by a height of h. So u equal to mgh. This is a relation of gravitational potential energy. Now, what about kinetic energy? Is denoted by capital K. For kinetic energy, how will I derive the form? Say for example, a body which is initially at rest. Or say we can also derive in this way, kinetic energy is the energy which is possessed by a body due to the work done by the body until it comes to a rest. That means till it comes to a rest. Now what will happen? When the body comes to rest, what will be the final velocity then? Zero. So do you remember Newton's laws of motion and the equations of motion? The equations of motion, one was there. Now in this case, v means final velocity, zero. U is equal to say the velocity with which it is moving. And 2as, a is the acceleration and s is the displacement. Now see, in this case, what will happen? So what is the force basically? What is the force here? D, that means the displacement. Force is mass into acceleration. What is displacement here? Kinetic energy is half mv square. So instead of u, basically I'm writing v. That's all the same, because in this case, why am I writing minus v square equal to u square minus 2s? Because it's the retarding force. Instead of a, that means plus a, it will be minus. Why? Because some force is trying to stop it. So that is why we calculate kinetic energy as the work done, which is done on the body till the body comes to a rest. Two expressions which we have just calculated. U is equal to mgh, that means the potential energy equation. Now see, if we raise a body from h1 to h2, that means suppose if I raise a body from certain height to a greater height, its potential energy will increase because it's raised to a greater position. So obviously if h increases, the gravitational potential energy will obviously increase. Now the gain in energy, obviously there will be a gain in energy, mg h2 minus h1, because at height h1 it will be mg h1, at h2 mg h2. If we drop a body from h2 to h1, that means from a greater height to a lower height. So the height is decreasing, that means potential energy will decrease. So loss in potential energy, that will be mg h1 minus h2. Now let's have a look at kinetic energy. See, this you need to know because you get numericals from this part. Relationship between what is P? Linear momentum. P is a linear momentum, which is mass into velocity. This was covered in Newton's laws of motion. Second law of motion it was covered, because when we calculated the force term. So P equal to mass into velocity. Now just see, if I just square it, P square equal to M square V square. So from there, we get this. And I can substitute the value of V square from this equation, which I have done. So ultimately you get P equal to root over 2MK. That means if linear momentum is given, mass is given, we can find kinetic energy. And vice versa. That means linear momentum mass, kinetic energy are related in this way, in this equation. Now say, if I say two bodies having same kinetic energy, okay, two bodies having same kinetic energy are moving. Which one? One is heavier, another one is lighter. So which one will have more momentum? Obviously, the one having more mass, because see, from here, can't I write? That means if P is more, M is more, P is more, provided K constant, right? That means, suppose if two bodies A and B, A, the mass is, mass of body A is greater than mass of body B, provided kinetic energy, both the bodies are same, then which one will have more momentum? A. Heavier body moves with greater momentum. And what about if two bodies having same momentum but moving with different kinetic energies, then which one will have more kinetic energy, lighter body or heavier body? See, the lighter body will have more kinetic energy, because in this case kinetic energy right, so or also we can see from here M is inversely proportional to K. So if two bodies are moving with same momentum, then in that case, if MA is greater than MB, then that means the lighter body will move with greater kinetic energy, because it is inversely proportional. Okay, so these are the consequences. You need to know these consequences. Also, this formula for doing the numericals, and this formula also. Okay. Now,